fast.
And that seems to be microphoning. Okay, so I'm going to start the video now. I think you're ready to go. And let's also start the recording to the cloud. Anybody else that wants to record can record. Okay.
Hey, Rick, I think I'll take over a co-host for this one, okay? Rick, are you sharing the video by chance? Can you make the other Vince? Can you make the other Vince co-host, please, sir? Yeah, that was the phone. Sorry. Okay, we're ready to go then.
You have people listening from every corner of this planet. No knowledge has been dispersed so beautifully, so balanced across the planet, on this planet ever, maybe in the universe. You have the full potential of achieving everything in the universe. There is no need and there is no reason for man not to achieve. So, wherever you are, the way I taught you to make the coils double fall inside, you have continuous eco-gravitational magnetic field, and if you put CO2 on it, and you put zinc on it, you have connected the emotion of the man to it on a stable condition, and you'll find out you become a very peaceful man. Here, instead of having galaxies and universes and creating connection magnetically, we have used the matter state gravitational magnetic field strength to dominate and dictate the shape of the plasma. The nano technology, the nanomaterial which you have collectively developed in different ways by caustic, by electric currents, by whatever, fire or whatever, has that advantage that the matter, the nano and the plasma is all the same. So connection is very solid. It's very strong. The power of the plasma technology, the way we have thought, is beyond imagination of the mind. Now you can create and control the plasma, which is the mother of the creation of the universe. You are given the seed of the essence of the creation. The foundation does not belong to no one and is not made of one anymore. You are developing it. You are structuring it. And from today, we will be still the same. We'll still develop the technology in different names, in different colors, in different nationalities, which they do not exist. It is beautiful when we see the Christian, the Muslims, the Jews, and every other belief are working together to build up systems. We have already become one faith. We already have become one nation, and we already become one planet. You got to remember one thing. Dates is irrelevant. Today is the last day of the Christian calendar, or tomorrow is the beginning of another. One day is connected to another. We don't stop. We are working round the clock. The Keshe Foundation team is working irrespective of time, position, religion, country. And now we achieve what we set out for.
Would you like to be one of the first humans in space using plasma technology? The Keshe Foundation Spaceship Institute is now taking applications for the Man-Originated Zone Habitation and Nutrition Training Program, or MOJAN. The goal of MOJAN is to teach trainees how to create and utilize the magnetically oriented joint habitation and nutrition system that will be used for life in space. Be one of the first humans in space using plasma technology. The 3-month MOJAN training program begins in the fall of 2016. Apply today at mojan.kfssi.org. Trainees will be taught every aspect of plasma technology needed for them to go to space and survive, and will be educated in space ethos. Participants are expected to bring the knowledge forward to the peoples of their nations to prepare them to become peoples of space. Matter propulsion technology. To date on Earth, we use inefficient and costly rocket propulsion technology, which burns fuels to overcome the magnetic gravitational fields of the planet to go to space. We power our rockets, our cars, and our homes by burning matter to release the energy that we convert from one form to another in order to create motion and usable energy. As well, to achieve objectives, rockets, for example, have to carry large and heavy payloads of fuel, which means that they're payload dependent. Matter propulsion technology is very destructive, inefficient, polluting, and wasteful. Now, let's look at the new alternative, plasma technology. Plasma technology uses the properties of the entirety of plasma to create motion, lift, and energy without destroying the characteristics of matter. The system utilizes magnetic and gravitational field interaction to attain positioning and motion. Nothing is burned, there's no waste, and no pollution is created. Plasma technology is efficient and not destructive. Current human scientific achievement is the result of a progressive evolution in science and technology over thousands of years. Plasma technology is the next step in that evolution. It's viable, and it's here today. You could be one of the first humans in space using plasma technology. Apply today to the Mojan training program. The Universal Council invites you to attend the One Planet, One Nation, One Race event in Rome on the 9th and 10th of September 2016. The Council looks forward to open interaction with the public at the event. Come interact with the Council in your spoken language. The Council encourages you to bring your positive suggestions and solutions to the table on how humanity can move forward as a whole towards everlasting peace. In this way, the work of the members of the Council will become the work of humanity for humanity. The full package price for a single ticket to the event includes 3-night stay in one of Rome's prestigious hotels, daily attendance to the event, as well as breakfast on the 9th through the 11th, and lunch and tea on the 9th and 10th. Accommodations for this package is based on double occupancy. The full package price for 2 tickets to the event includes 3-night stay in a twin bed room in one of Rome's prestigious hotels, daily attendance to the event, as well as breakfast on the 9th through the 11th, and lunch and tea on the 9th and 10th. Additional nights stay are offered at €150 per person per night. For those who wish to arrange their own accommodations and who plan on attending a single day of the event, the cost will be €200, which includes tea and lunch on the day of the event. For those who wish to arrange their own accommodations and who plan on attending both days of the event, the cost will be €400, which includes tea and lunch on the day of the event. The One Planet, One Nation, One Race event in Rome. Come share your positive solutions on how we can work together to bring everlasting peace to our world.
Welcome, everyone, to the 118th Knowledge Seekers Workshop of the Keshe Foundation Spaceship Institute. And once again, we're gathered here on Thursday every week for the last 117 Knowledge Seekers Workshops. And today is June 16th, 2016. And once again, Mr. Keshe will be here and telling us what's happening in the world of the Keshe Foundation for this week. Mr. Keshe, are you ready to go there now?
Yes, thank you very much, Rick. Good morning, good day to you. As usual, as we say, wherever and whenever you listen to these Knowledge Seeker sessions, as usual, we make our announcements at the beginning of every session in what is happening and what's to happen. And then we depart in a way of actually going to understand the part of what we started earlier on, about a year ago. We go into detail, you'll understand. One of the main announcements we have to make is for we made this on Tuesday, we're repeating it again today for those of you who don't listen to the Tuesday teachings. In respect to the Magrav systems, there is a development and we would like you to follow the new development and feed us back the results. The Magrav units now they are in operation for nearly over 6 months around the world, over 6 months, by those which were released by the Keshe Foundation and by those which you made yourselves. As we are developing this technology together on an open source platform, We share knowledge, we learn everything together, and that has become the success for the technology. At the beginning, introducing a new technology, we had to play a very safe game in a way that we could understand the progress of development of the plasma within the structure of the units, which we went through 5-6 days of blueprint teaching. If you remember from the beginning, when you made the Magrav systems, we asked you when you connected to your main, you make a load of around about 1200 watt power to trigger the plasma. In the process of development and testing, and a lot of you shared knowledge with us, and we kept monitoring our own systems and finding more and more easier way to be able to work, and we did not have to do such a thing. We came slowly to reduce the power to 600, and we came down to 400. In the past few weeks, we announced 15 watt Magrav system LED light was to be used, will do the work. What we are seeing now in the process of development from people who made the systems and people who are using the Magrav systems manufactured by Keshe Foundation is evolution in the full science. What we see now is that when you are using these loads to trigger the plasma in your Magrav system, you are paying extra cost. 600 watts or 400 watts, 24 hours is another 8 kilowatts of energy, and if you run it for 30 days to trigger it, it builds up. What we see now and is working, and we ask you to convert into, is all of you in the house have a refrigerator. Where now when you get your Magrav system or you build your Magrav system, you don't need to load it up any extra. Connect your refrigeration system to the Magrav load. So, from now on, there is no additional cost in the house. The system does not bear additional cost to come. So, it's plug and use directly into your fridge system. The fridge freezer system, because of the system, the cooling system, the compression and the motors which are in it, and they oscillate with a high use drop for a few watts because of the controls, thermometers or whatever, thermostats in the back, they go, stay low, and then they peak up. So, they have a cycle which is very much long-term, short-term, long-term, short-term because of the compressor, and they, in a way, if you look at it, follow the impulse of electricity. They come, they low, they go, and this process brings both AC and DC out of the system. And what we have seen is a very rapid response in reduction in power use in some of the system which has been used like this, or most of them. So, you don't need to add any more refrigeration, any more LED light or extra lights. When you receive your units, or even if you are using units at home which you connected to a light to begin going, just move it to where your refrigeration is, which every household on this, in most of the Western world have, and you will see, you don't have to worry about any additional cost of running the system, it's part of the system which you are already using. But you will see a continuous reduction in your supply from the grid, and your hybrid system of the plasma will supply the rest. There is a key point in this process. We are trying to evaluate, we're trying to assess if you are correct. And that is, over time, when you use refrigeration system, the plasma technology of your Magrav system becomes gradually into a generator. which means you start generating electricity, or not the electricity, but the pre-plasma, which can be used for any application. This is the breakthrough. This is what we are looking at, and we would like you to test it with your system. We've seen it in over 5 occasions, so there is a pattern to it. System which has been used over 6 months show some of them such a property, which means you change your Maglev unit through the continuous charge and discharge through the refrigeration system, releases the plasma on an orderly manner, and your system becomes a generator. This is what we are trying to establish, and we'd like a lot of you to try it, because now is no addition, just plug it in. What we see, we would like you to check, this is exactly again part of the blueprint. If you've been with us, you know exactly what you got to do with it, is that switch off the main power supply at the meter. And then look at your power supply, your Maglev unit. One of the easiest way we've seen, open the door of the fridge and see if the light is on in the fridge still. If the light in the fridge is still on by switching the main, you have become a generator system. But you have to place the Maglev system at the point of the entrance of the electricity into the house, because what you got to do, your unit with its extension has to be changed that it can take most of the demand of the house, 2, 3, 4 kilowatt. Now your plug end becomes the supply end to the house. This is what we need you, those of you who understand, to test and report back that we establish a criterion for all of it. What we have seen in one occasion, but we will establish, we go further, and we would like you to test, because we know a lot of you are there testing these things. When you put a Maglev system, and some of you who have 2 Maglev system, and you connect your refrigeration here, and you have multi-plug, and you connect one of these plugs to a second unit, a second Maglev unit. We call this, if you remember, originally a cascading. It seems that the Maglev unit, in conjunction with the 2, create what is called free plasma transmission. We need to clarify this. We need, as we work as one team on this planet, it's for us to evaluate it if it's correct. We have seen it happening. I was present when it happened in a flash of light, but the system was short. But we are trying in the Innovation Center to evaluate this. We do it, you do it, because we work this way, where the system, the field system, between the 2 creates an environment of free energy, wireless energy, which means your systems can operate without anything else. We've seen the lighting in the LED light, in the light which was switched off, which was, there was no way it could be a connection. The light, ceiling light totally off, comes on. So this is a part of the progress into generation and wireless power supply. Very much like the masts you have, a receiver, a transmitter. But what we think in the long term is they start feeding and transmitting at the same time. So one becomes the feeder of the other, and the other becomes the feeder of the other, and you create what was the dream of our beloved Tesla. Creation of the field where you can tap into it if you have 110 or 220, already see, because it's a plasma, it converts to what you needed according to what you have beside it. But there is one proviso to this. The reason you keep the plug into the wiring circuit of the house is because we need a potential difference balance between the plasmas, and it seems that this connection, if you keep it connected to the wall, to the earth, you create that potential difference between the plasma and the field, gravitational magnetic field of the earth, which allows it to create the difference and the release of the plasma. So you need to have a connection, what you call in electrical terms, an earth connection to your MagRav system. So if you disconnect it and just plug it in to the wall, or make a connection to the ground, some of you who are wizarding these things say you have to hammer a nail or a bar so many centimeters into the ground, you get the same effect. You need to have an earth connection at least on one of the MagRav systems. So we see now, we have started safely, all of us, we followed, we saw the MagRav system coming into operation. Some of us could not have a good result because we were using LED lights and LED power, because this was the safest way to go. Some of you used the generators and the heaters and you saw a better result. Now, with the refrigeration unit, which is in every house, we can kick this in. We showed you a video of this with our Italian teacher in an Italian teaching group in his house last week. We've seen this one months ago in London. I saw this months ago in Philippines with one of our researchers. But we could not connect it. Now it's very clear. We have two other occasions which we see the same progress, and so we advise you to switch, because it's been going on for long enough, and we see. In overall what we see, as you know, in London, the meter was changed last September for checking if it was correct by the power supplying company. The reader, the meter was read 8th of January, and the power reading was zero. This was a surprise at that time. But now we understand the MagRav system, which was connected to the fridge, was the trigger. So we expect over time your power supply as a MagRav unit to become your generator. So we are not in any way promoting it at this moment, but as we work on an open platform source, we see such a result. This is the beauty of sharing knowledge unconditionally. We are not afraid. You are not afraid of testing and letting us know. Test and change. We advise you now, change all your systems into refrigeration as a payload, as a load site. That we start seeing, and you start seeing the benefit of it. We've seen this in Africa. In Africa, a lot of people, the most precious thing they have in the house is the fridge. And they always connected it. So we've seen in Africa 95% reduction in the first month. Now we understand partially why. And these are all the top scientists who work with Ghanaian and the Kenyan governments and the others who took the systems. So there is a precedence for this move. Connect your MagRav system to a refrigerator on the payload, and please report back that we can develop. Most of you who took MagRav units, you bought MagRav units from the Keshe Foundation, you most probably should receive an email advising you to do this. This is the beauty, because we've done transaction with you online. So you receive information from the Keshe Foundation in that you change your MagRav system to fridge as a load. Please do, and let us know. If you're saving, let's say 30-50%, let's see if we can push you to 100%, where your MagRav system becomes a generator. This is important. Let us see if it's correct, and then we fulfill the dream of Tesla. But through plasma technology and not magnetic field. This way, we be able to complete, and as we said, the Magra power units become as a generator. And then we start seeing other effects of the total use of the power units, like their application for health, their application for food, their application for material production. This is important. So please check and let us know, and we go to the next step. The other announcement is, number of you have signed in to be members of Motion team. Filling the application form, we don't do nothing. We just see you're signing in, number of people fill in, have a look, and fill the form in. Till the payment is not arrived, we don't consider you just a dot as you filled up the application form. And then, on the other hand, within the next few weeks, I close the teaching, which means we don't accept anymore because of the situation which the Keshe Foundation has found itself in a space technology. So, if you applied to be Motions, please complete the whole process of the payment. Go through the clearance within the next 2 weeks, 3 weeks, because I will close it. I prefer to have a very tight, close number of people to teach in a couple of hundred than going and sitting up in lectures. Because you have to make the units. We try to set up a facility where most of the things can be done in a different way. The other thing is, in respect to Rome, is the same. Fill it in, because we're going to close it very soon, that it moves, because we have to bring the member of the Universal Council in. We are structuring it. There is a matter of huge security around Rome for us. So, very close, very shortly, we close this Rome totally. This is partly because of what is happening in the background of the Keshe Foundation, the development and the rest of it. As a lot of you know, in the situation we announced this week, today, we will clarify points in regarding the case of Alan Sterling with the Keshe Foundation. We've been advised by our security and the team who sit behind as advisor of the foundation, as the sentencing is tomorrow in United States. We stay offline and we will release the position of the Keshe Foundation through the supporters of Keshe Foundation next Thursday. We have found a massive cooperation in the background, and we keep it in that point. And as we said, we exposed everything on the international arena, and we leave it to be judged by the people. The other point is in respect to what we spoke about and what we said months ago in respect to the earthquakes and position of the southern continent of America. This part of the teaching is a teaching, but explaining in more detail, and is on the request and our respect to our colleague, Professor Hill of Chinese Space, which they have asked for clarification. And as respected scientists, I'll explain this today in a detail that the totality is understood, because this, what is to happen, has a huge implication for governments, and they want to see the validity, and they want to see the terms and the conditions they have to condition their country in the coming time. As we said before, the Chinese Keshe Foundation team and the groups which work in the background, working very actively to complete the OASIS system to be ready for eventuality of the crisis or any crisis which might come up. And they have targeted the production of 2 tons of guns and are busy with it. And they want more explanation. What is the position, how we see it, and what we expect. So today, this is a gift to Professor Gill of the Chinese Space Institute, which is asked He asked a simple question yesterday, and I said, I explained in a simple way, and I explained today, I explain in more detail. We're going to spend about an hour and a half, but we go through step by step to understand the process and why we see this and why we see nations have to take a step. As we said, the earth, as we are all aware, even though we walk on a solid part, is on a bed of rotating molten material. And inside that molten metal, for years, the assumption was that the blanketing of so much material on the top creates the heating of the inside, and that's why it's warm. And that's why we have molten metal. In fact, with evolution, and evolution in the science and what we have released and other scientists have, now we have a very clear idea, more or less, that the heating of the center of the planet is created due to the interaction of the plasma of different strength, matter, nanomaterial and the rest, and the interaction of the fields of these with each other in different directions and positions creates both gravitational and magnetical fields of the planet. Where the release of the plasmatic field with different matter states in the reduction from the high plasmatic field strength to low matter state interaction leads to the heating of the material, and then in heating it creates, due to interaction of the matter and the plasma of the field into the rotation of the planet in the clock or anti-clockwise. But at the same time, as the further you come, you'll find different materials, which is on the gaseous part of the planet, in interaction with the matter part, lead to creation of what we call the oceans or whatever. You call it mountain range, you call it mountains, land part mass and the rest. So, what we see is, if you understand the principle of how plasmatic magnetic field inside the center of the planet, in reduction in strength, in interaction with the other matter state or the field state, doesn't matter if it's a liquid or gas, leads to motion of the whole structure, where stronger field with a weaker field interaction creates a motion, as part of the energy is dissipated as heat and the rest as motion. And if you understand this, you understand how the upper part is a floating boat on the magma, where does not matter how deep the oceans go and how high the mountains are developed. The whole structure is within the structure of floating magma, which is forced and dictated by the fields of the gravitational magnetic field strength of the center of the plasma of the planet. This applies the same to a star, applies the same to any moon, applies the same to a plasma of a proton or plasma of electron. At the boundary of the interaction is the conformation of the physicality, where there is a both gravitational magnetic field balance. In this process, our planet is no different than the others. The magma moves, what has become solid moves on top of it. Somewhere at the bottom, in a very gray area, the totality comes together. But this part has connection both with the matter and the magma. So, whatever is on the top is on the float. And if you have a mass and you can penetrate part of it and weaken it, you can bend it. If you have a piece of metal or you have a piece of paper, if you cut into it and then play with it. You break it, you bend it, you do whatever you like with it. And somehow, in the past history of this planet, in occasion, we do not know, it's been indicated to be through hitting of a meteorite in a Mexican Gulf, that we see a split in the structure of the northern and a southern part of a continent. So, a weakness in this structure has been created, which sits at this moment somewhere around Panama. If you understand this, now you have very much a continent in one piece. Fabio, could we have a camera, please? The what you have is what it was, a solid piece. Now it has a dent in it. And this dent we call Gulf of Mexico. But in so many ways, further down and everything else with it, you go further down, there is another below Gulf of Mexico and the rest of it, we have a weakness in this position. And if you understood that the whole structure of this planet is on a revolving magma, which is rotating anti-clockwise, then you understand, now that you have a weakness and the magma is moving, now you see what's happening. The southern American continent is floating away on the direction of the float of the magma. But there is another factor into this, that this magma is not just floating in one direction, is floating in the other direction too. And it's done this for millions of years. And now it's come to the point that it cannot be, you get a piece of metal and bend it back and forth, up and down, in two different directions, push, it'll break up. And this break is now in this point, on this planet. This has been developing because it's been part of the same, what we see on the west coast of United States, on a Pacific Ocean, this tearing apart has been taking place, and we call it Ring of Fire, because it goes to the other side, because it's pulling itself apart, because it's connected by Pangaea on the top to the rest of the mass, Asian continent, African, European continent. So this, as it's getting pulled over past centuries, in ripping apart, has been creating an opening for it to happen. And that's why we see the Ring of Fire. Because that's why we see the volcanic eruptions. The whole material is pulling apart, it has to give way. So now we understand the process of why we have the Ring of Fire. We understand when you have this and you have matter-state connection, in tearing apart in the continental plates, this has been creating what we call the earthquakes, it's been the heavy earthquake zones. And then on the other side of this, which sits the Asian continent, has to react too. So it's under pressure and under contraction. It's getting pulled by magma in one end through Indian Ocean, under the Indian Ocean, and by the other way, the pull from the top is both ways. The whole planet is continuously has a heartbeat. It's exactly like your heart. It's moving. And in that process, the Southern American continent is on the verge of separation. That's why we see such a huge amount of earthquake activities in the past few years, in past decades and centuries, now has come to a massive separation. The separation, we announced, this is about to happen. Never before any scientific organization or any papers spoke about the separation of two continents. I explained this for the first time last year, and now we see it in progress. When such a position takes place, the show is correct, and we explain the pressures we're going to see on a southern European and on the Chinese line with Iran and the rest back into the place of the America to confirm it. Everything now in past few months coming together to confirm the correctness. So when the pressure is coming on the continental plates and is going up and down, so we should see huge activities on the line of the separation. Earthquake, geological, but the only problem which now appears, as we said, go back into my talks, with this separation, we feel the earthquake in Washington and New York. Because this separation is pulling apart, the bottom part is pulling, but the top part is locked into Pangaea, into European continent, North American part of the connection into the North Pole mass, into the Asian continent and the rest of it. So this part is free, but this part, the top part, is pushing against the others. This can go, this can't go. So what it's doing is squeezing into this part, which now, this is why we start seeing massive earthquakes and volcanic eruption conditions in pushing the magma through in Yellowstone Park area. We start seeing huge pressure till this pressure is absorbed. The volcanic eruption will take place. The pressure is released. In releasing the pressure, it creates a shock. And in that shock, the continent will separate. But now the continent of America, Southern America, becomes afloat. The back end of what is left as a northern continent, now that the push has gone, it'll go to go back to normality of past centuries of separation push. This will create a feedback earthquake into Chinese, Japan. We saw Fukushima was the first sign of this kickback because the releases on the lower level plates have already started. And now we see the beginning of the separation and the start of the massive earthquake, massive volcanic eruptions till the kickback comes in. But now this continent separated will go afloat. Will go afloat on the magma platform. This float is in that direction because the magma is moving that way. We've seen the earthquake in Gibraltar. We've seen the earthquake in south of Spain. We've seen on the same line, Austria, Switzerland, and Greece are reporting earthquake because this is coming this way. Now the pressure comes. There are two possibilities. The what we call Gibraltar, if the pressure builds up, will close. If the Pangaea can take the pressure of the continental Southern America release, will close the Suez Canal because the continent will be pushed to close to take this pressure. Or this continent will twist backwards and becomes like Australia, a continent at the bottom. The geology of the planet will change, the atmospheric condition of the planet will change, not only due to the eruptions, but now we lose one of the biggest landmass of jungles, which supplies huge amount of energy on this planet, and the oxygen will disappear because now it drops down, it's not on the equator line. This will happen over centuries, thousands of years, if the planet is still here. But what's going to happen in a coming time, as I explained in the private teaching this week, This planet is like a wheel of a car. When you buy a tire and you put it on the, what you call it, your ring, you balance it. And you add a few grams here, few grams there on the balancing machine, that the rotation is perfect. So when this mass starts separating, which is bring with itself, the planet has to balance itself. And in that balancing, a lot of oceans, current flow, which is the balancing forces on this planet, will change. We cannot change the landmass, but waters of this planet are floating landmass. We will see different directions of the water flows, and this different direction of water flows will create new atmospheric condition on this planet. These will be felt within the next 3 to 5 years, that's imminent. But on the other hand, the process of the development of the separation in the short term is seeding of a large number of the volcanic eruptions. The ring of fire will not exist, because now the totality pressure for separation has come out of the equation. But in this process, we will see massive earthquakes, because everything now that is separate is trying to settle. We will see huge number of eruptions, which will disturb the atmospheric balance, which our lives at this moment is depending on. You have too much dust in the air, no aircraft flies. Jetliners are landed. The economy of the Western world will come to a halt within the next 12 months. For sure, Northern American continents will become landmass with only connections with donkeys, horses, if you can still drive a car, and large number of people will depart from the United States within the next few months. Because you cannot, if the correction, the calculation is correct, the amount of the ashes released by these volcanic eruptions on balancing the earthquakes to support the separation will cover most of the United States. In my writing, knowing this a few weeks ago to the world leaders in a way which was a message passed on, is, would there be an election in November in the United States? Or as we suggested, it is better for Senate to make a provision to appoint President Obama for a third term, because nobody will be there to run the nation except the man who is already in power. Now you understand why we address this on the political level as much as the economical level. You have to understand the economy of the United States is dependent on its military influences, which is created, financed by the British Isles and the Europeans. In losing the manpower of armed forces, the economy of the Europe will collapse in a matter of hours. The moment the eruption happens anywhere on this line and the earthquakes, we lose the what we call the false powerhouses of the world. Then this brings Russia and China as the world leaders, both economically and influentially. Look at the data which is raised by the American scientists in respect to the eruption, not what we do here. So this is important, that is understood by the American government and by the European government. This is time of cleaning up, but the process is very reverse. For 500 years, people of different continents took to America. Now, not much left, most of the land unusable, they'll go back home. Most of the nations have to be able to be ready for exodus back into their nation. People will claim every right. My grandfather was this, and my great-grandfather was Indian. I'm going back to India, because there is no America left, the way we know it. The process has started. We are witnesses to part of the evolution of the life of this planet, which we are passengers of the dry land. So, now you understand the extent of what is about to happen, and what I've asked, we've shown in our teaching on Tuesday, private teaching, we bring it on the surface for you to see the data. This is what I explain in theory, and what is sitting, and how the process started. And now, we go through the next step. Don't forget, Australia was separated through the same process, millions of years ago. British Isle used to be part of a desert. If you go to Sheffield, in more or less center of England, there is a cement factory called Blue Circle. If you go there, in the factory, where they are digging the things out, one of the first things they tell you, this what we're digging was part of an ocean and a desert. That's why we can produce the sand we need from this area, for our cement factory. I've been there, I lived in England, I did a project on that factory. Because the geology of the land at that time was important to me to understand. So, now we understand in the process what is going to happen. The American continent free, the Southern American continent free, the Northern American continent will flex back. It's literally, if you look at it, I brought you a stick. This is what it used to be. Fabio, can we see this on the camera? Or do you want me to come close? Is he there or is he gone? No. What it is very much like a stick, but a bigger stick, you call it a continent. Can you see it? So, what has happened? This pressure on the bottom, through the magma, is pulling the continent and is breaking. So, it has broken. And that's it. So what happened? This was the continent under pressure, it has broken and it's going to take apart. And we're seeing the last part of this separation. And what happened, as you saw, when the break comes, this takes its position and this has to start floating on the magma. This is the position we are in now. And in this process, as the mass, the big mass, the Pangaea itself, the main body of the Pangaea on the top sits, it has to take the pressure of this change this way too. But this land mass is huge, can take pressure of Southern American continent with a little bit of changes. Changes will come with close of Gibraltar or opening of the Gibraltar in different way. If Gibraltar opens up due to the pressure on this African part, then Suez Canal will close, because Saudi Arabia, what we call mass, in here somewhere, is the flexing point. Most probably, we see the end of Persian Gulf too, in hundreds of years, because it will collapse. That way, we see a massive flooding into the Central Europe, or Western Europe, by the way the process happens. But most of us will not be here to see this. But this is the process, we are witness in a frame as part of it. So, what we're going to do, we're going to show you, to show what we say about the separation is imminent, is from data. Rick, can we go back into the pictures and can I have a snapshot fingers that we can talk about it, please?
Yeah, I have that here. I'll share that up.
This process will affect the life of every man on this planet. Every one of you who are listening will be affected. You have no choice. You have no choice. None of us have a choice, but there is a fair solution. Can you open this up, please, into a frame? Can we have the earthquake in past 24 hours on this scale, please? Can we have the earthquake in past 24 hours? You got it?
Yeah, this is the past 24 hours.
You can click on hide the volcanoes if you want as well.
Okay. You can put the volcano, the earthquakes, and the volcano, please.
Okay, both. Then.
Can you bring the American... Can we go a slightly different, because we don't see the North American continent? Yeah. No. Okay. Where are we now? No, we want the whole of the planet. If you can reduce it slightly, please. Okay, now we have a whole of Africa back into the Asia. We are looking.
You need to go in a little further because you got everything duplicated with Africa twice there.
I know. There's no other zoom ratio other than that.
Just a little bit, please. That's perfect. It's okay. Yeah. You only have one side, which is nothing on it. It's perfect.
Okay.
This is the earthquake in past 24 hours. Am I correct? And the volcanic eruptions?
24 hours, and then just the eruptions are right here.
Okay. These are the eruptions, and can we have the earthquakes, please?
Yep, they're all there. All the earthquakes are there in the past 24 hours. So the circles are the earthquakes. The size of the circle indicates bigger earthquakes, and then the actual erupting volcanoes are in the red triangles.
Okay. This is what you see, and this is what they explain. That's the 24 hours. Look at the mass movement between the north and south. Can we go in past 48 hours, please? You have one which is the yellow and the red one. Can we have that one?
Let's see here. This would be the last week.
Last week?
It would be orange now.
Yeah.
And then...
past 2 weeks, please.
Here's the 2 weeks. And then if I bring in the volcanoes, here's the ones that are, say, like warning or minor activity in the orange triangles.
Now you see what we speak about. The concentration of the earthquakes on this point, and you see Central America, you see Yellowstone area, you see the earthquakes on this, because now the pressure is going here. Once this let go in the next 3 to 6 months, this flexes back. All this are due to this expansion, and now you see what I explained. The feedback will go through China, exactly the line I explained 8 months ago. We see Switzerland, Gibraltar, Austria, Greece will come into operation. And the indication are what I said before, the pressure of this continent will move close the Suez and the Persian Gulf. Because you see the... I lost it. You see, most of the activity sits here. Now we start seeing the activities here. We don't see activities anywhere else, which means the continent, Africa, will tilt. And this will close. And now what you see, the building of the pressure for separation is here, and this is getting pushed. You will see this, seismological data confirms, and if you go back, we can go in the last year, then you will see a very clear pattern in what has happened and what is about to complete. Any of these volcanic eruptions come simultaneously, the more or less Pacific area will be totally darkened for a time to come. Zero flight zone. This is why I wrote to the governments in a very straightforward, have your naval forces ready for picking up as many boats as you can, as people will take into the oceans. And we are about to happen. This is on the verge. We estimate this winter, this autumn, it'll be the last push where the push of the magma and a change of the season will bring this stuff in. And what we've seen in the activities in This side of United States confirms the pressure is building up. The building, if we can go on the 51 states seismological data, they have switched two. Recently they switched the third one off for a short time, brought it back on. It's so heavy that they don't want the state to go into panic state. But it shows the compression. That's why on 22nd, 23rd of this month, American government is putting into act, testing a 9-scale earthquake testing. But that would be totally useless. The problem with this situation is because of the magnitude of the eruption. Nowadays, there is an earthquake, we fly things in, we try to get in fast. When you have these kind of eruptions, there is no flight. We have to rely on naval forces to be able to reach to support. 2 months, 3 months. Are we going back to the situation of crossing the English Channel with a boat to get as many people as back from the shores of France? Because there is no flight. Now you understand two options left and why we are pushing with this technology development. First of all, as many people as learn in how to use the plasmatic fields, the GANs, the nanomaterials, the what you call Chinese are concentrating on OASIS system, the more people you can protect without the need, at least time, for under support. The other way, with a plasma technology of what you call MAGRA positioning flight system, as you create the shielding, is irrelevant if you're going through a dust to go through the water or you go through a volcanic eruption. You can reach, deliver and be able to support life within minutes. Reaching, supporting American citizens will become the duty of every man on this planet. And if we have a knowledge, we can do. But now, this is a pre-warning. The same goes with the government of Iran. On a feedback, on a kickback, as we see, the line of fire sits right across Iran. Southern France, Spain, Portugal will be more or less shaking like bucket of jelly. We will not see much on the Chinese west coast, but we'll see through Japan. We'll see heavy involvement in the Japanese sector. Pressure will change in a drastic way, and then the odd earthquakes Chinese government can handle. The pattern, the picture is very clear. You cannot see, I try to go black. Oh, I'm there. I've got to use this. The line is here. If you can't see it, I change it to a green, but you can see it better. You see the line?
Yes, that works. Thank you.
And now, you see the warning we have given. It's to the benefit of governments to act now, not leave it when it's too late, because there'll be no nation to have elections. When we announced in February, April, we saw immediate response from the White House in setting up organizations for the earthquake support. Now they're testing it, but Your Excellency President Obama, you're too late. Acted too late, delivered too late, and your nation will not be there to support it in the coming months. This is what we said there is no need for armies because all the armies of the world will become naval forces trying to save their own citizens and the others. You look South America, millions affected. The whole of Central Asia, the Silk Road will be totally devastated one after another. It's not going to happen overnight. 1 week here, next week there. There is not enough resources on this planet to support such a change. Unless we all get trained how to support ourselves. There'll be no more or less Hawaii left, because it'll take what is not taken by the earthquake and volcanic eruption, will be taken by tsunamis. This will bring Earth into a new position on its own in the solar system. Our warning goes to the world governments, hardly any of you will survive this one. The only possible nation which can come out of this is China and US or Russia. Western Europe, we will not know any more Western Europe, because EU will break up because financially cannot support some 10 nations to be totally devastated. They all will claim their independence. They were good as much as they could rob each other. Now they have to support, they are not there, it doesn't exist. This is why in the past few months, in a very silent way, British are fully aware of my work as I live there and they understand when I speak, they're speaking the separation from EU. Because they don't want to be in it when it's coming in. The rest will happen, one at a time. All the East Asian nations will be devastated. We've seen it in 2005. We'll see the repetition in the coming months and years. All these have to be readjusted. They've been pulled apart. And now when they let go, they have to go back to theirs to seal up. And these create new earthquakes. Most of the volcanic systems will shut down by the release of the southern American continent. The problem is how few million supporters of the Keshe Foundation around the world can bring this process to act. We leave the Americans to be. There is something I gave a warning to the Islamic world in a hidden code. Now I open it. When the American continent goes through such a change, the 52nd state of United States, Israel, will not exist because there is nobody to protect the Jews. It's the job of the Israelis to patch up very quickly, because what you relied on, the father will not be there to feed. They have too much to look after inside. The process is a natural, is not planned by no one. Maybe it's the time of correction. The Arab states, the Palestinians, will not let Israel exist for 1 minute. They've done wrong enough to be cleaned up. So now we see the danger sitting on the horizon and why we call for rapid move in September for unification of mankind, before we get to this position. Bury the hatches, whatever has happened wrong to each other, we done to each other. But when that earthquake goes, when the Yellowstone and other volcanic eruptions goes, when there is no transportation across the United States to get and launch rockets, there will be no state of Israel. This is why we call on the government of China to take the leadership for the human race at this stage. because it's the only nation financially, politically correct and solid that can carry this through. Now you hear about little earthquakes, little eruptions, but when you put it in a map like this, you see it as we are watching it, new circles are getting added. If you watch this in the background, you see continuously circles are getting added in the same line. Updating is not as it was when we started. A few has happened. You see it, it just came in here. We just see additional yellow there. The process of the separation will change the food chain supply, will change the energy supply the way we are used to it, will change the whole structure of the geopolitics on this planet. And it all started, and there is no way anybody can stop. The clock is ticking. My advice to the American government is stop the whole election process, stop investing all the money in how you can develop different technologies that you can save your nationals. And the other point is, once this happens, this is what I said in the talk a couple of days ago. Up to now, the Africans and the Asians needed a visa and a passport. We check it before you can come, because we abused you for centuries, you got used to it. American passport needs clearance at least 12 months. You have to clear, you never touch the gun, you have to clear, you never kill the man, you have to show you've never bought any shares. But unfortunately, your central data is gone, you stay where you are. There will be no rooms for animal behavior. And this is where we are in the right time to deliver what we are supposed to do. You have a European passport, you are grounded, because you raped the world for centuries. Now you stay where you are, because we don't want you anymore. The position is very clear. This is not a doomsday, this is the evolution of the physiological planet living a life, and now a child separating from the mother. You see how, if you patch Australia into it, where it came from, the same position more or less will happen to Southern American continent. The pressures are too high, will not go to fit in, it will twist. It will literally go this way, and the Southern American continent, if you can get a color to it, will be somewhere here. Because the force of the magma is much freer on this end, will push this tip end, and this end will follow it in. Central African nations stay solid. Russian and Chinese, most part, will stay solid. Part of the Silk Road will be affected. Himalaya will go. Everest will play new game. Damawan in Iran will blow within the next few months, because it's part of the pressure now is getting squeezed. You seen the earthquakes? The pressure is building up this way.
We can't hear anything anymore. I guess the battery is empty again.
You seem to have lost your audio there. No doubt the batteries. We need some plasma batteries for that thing, I think.
Yep.
I think Mr. Cash will be back in just a minute here.
Am I back? Hello?
Yes, yes, thank you. Thank you very much.
Now, a battery gone. Imagine the whole nation goes, you hear nothing. Don't forget, the effect of this process is huge, because all these will start bursting into atmosphere, and some of this dust eventually block and affect the satellite communication. Is huge. The implication of what is about to happen, it started, not so what about happen. It's already started. We see it every minute, a shake and a tremble, and we see more and more higher magnitudes, 4 and 5, and more frequent, less frequent, in different part of the world. The pin was taken when the Chile happened last year. The earthquake on the west coast of Chile was the parallel to everything which was about to go. And we see massive amount of earthquake around Peru, because Peru is about to go. We'll see the end to most of these volcanic and earthquakes. East Asia becomes a safe place to be in 20 years, because all these volcanic eruptions finish. The level of the sea will change drastically, because up to now, the Pangaea has kept the little boy, Southern America, afloat. Now, it has to find its own position. It will rise. The level of sea in some parts, majority will drop up to 2 to 3 meters. Because at the moment it's taking the pressure. Now, when it's released, gradually it floats on its own on the magma. It will not sink that much, it'll rise most probably. So, we see most of the ports going down. Or, the water level will sink most of the ports. If you were involved in, after the, what you call, breakoff of USSR and opening of the canals between the open oceans and the Caspian Sea, you've seen how the ports disappear under the water. I've seen a couple of them. Because of a few meters not adjusted, you'll find out the ports are not there. I've been witness to a lot of changes in time. I told you, in a few times ago, a couple of weeks ago, I opened the Book of Humanity for humans to be ashamed of what they've done to themselves. And this is the beginning of it. We'll open. Everything man has done will be open for the man to see. It'll be very interesting, as I said before, how the human race, which raised to go to America, will race out of America. They came with a boat, they go back with a boat, because there'll be no space travel. But the only difference is 500 years of killing, destroying, and still carrying on with the same. Do we need them back, or we let them sink? My vote is, let the nature take its course. Because they'll come and they carry on with the same habit I've been seeing with the Jews. By giving them an estate, they became arrogance of the society in having a big boy supporting them. My call goes to the Jewish lobby. Sit on the table and talk with Keshe Foundation and find a solution for the State of Israel and amalgamate the Jews the way they were across the Arab world. We nourished you, we cherished you, and maybe now it's time back to go to the same process. But this, you see, just another one came on, flickering on, another earthquake. You see, they just flick, they just come on. This is a live condition. The problem is how fast we can come to an agreement with the government of China and Russia to build a safeguard for the Chinese and the Russians which go back to their countries after this mayhem in the coming time. Most of Western Europe cannot absorb millions of their own citizens. They don't have the facilities and financially they are bankrupt. If you go back on the internet, you see the warning I gave last year, put on by somebody in that snap, has been watched by a few million. So we are listened to a number of people, millions of people listen. Separate this section and put it on the internet of what is to come. And let's see what the people will decide. We don't get into military because military has no effect. There should not be and there shall be no borders. Those who went and they said, we've seen the last dictators moving, they'll see the last dictators will really move out in the next few months when there are no states to support. We got two choices. Controlling the situation with a new technology that we can support and take what comes, or stay on the state of arrogant and be the last man standing, shooting ourselves in the foot. And it seems that mankind has chosen the second option. If you understood what I deliberately started the teaching today, in explaining about the cascading of the units, would we create a condition that we can cascade with number of the reactors around the world, the whole of humanity to support. So, you see, the position is very clear. It's the end of one cycle for mankind and beginning of the other. The process will repeat itself most probably if this planet is on for billions of years to come with another part. It's happened here. I was explaining something very interesting. Maybe there is a truth in it. What we call that the planet Earth was hit by a meteorite and all the dinosaurs died was in reality not true. The reality where we see the end of the dinosaurs due to change of the climate most probably has come by the separation of the Australia. Australia in separation has created a smaller mayhem than a bigger brother, Southern America. If the mankind could trace this, you will see the separation of Australia from the main Pangaea was and created the main climate change. There was no meteorites. Don't ask me how I know. Put it this way, you'll find out I'm true, I'm correct. The process now will be so vast, if it manage to get rid of dinosaurs, with this separation and the process which we are going through, human race will be the ones who escaped into the caves. Maybe we have to escape into the nuclear silos to stay alive. If we can find enough copper using the nuclear materials, to make food and energy out of it. And then we emerge out of these holes in thousands of years when the planet is safe. Would there be a race, or would like another mammal take over? These are not jokes, these are part of the history of mankind on this planet. If you look at this map, I'll explain to you how human race was created. Human race, as a race, was not one. Due to the condition, the life was created simultaneously in different parts of this planet, and in time, when they came together, the stronger could take over another race. That's why you have blood type O, A and B, and the whole caboodle of it. The condition of life, now that you understand plasma technology, the gas technology, condition of the effect of the presence of salt and presence of water and the presence of elements of this planet, copper, zinc, and you have seen the existence of all these across this planet, more or less everywhere. Now you understand life in interaction with its gaseous parts and the matter part has led to life across this planet the same. How man came to go, as your theory says, from the East Africa, into what is assumed on the west, on the east coast, across and up, and creating the race, has little bit of truth in it, because the other race came through the center. The same in Southern America, the same in East Asia. The climate and the condition was correct for different races as beings were developed. That's why you will understand in so many ways the theory of existence of the man is all the same. We are 99 and we can depend on it, because the mouse, the cat, the dog, the fish, the man, all came from the interaction of the atmospheric gaseous with the element, and it has one option. Depends how you decided to run, or how you decided to stay steady and woke up and become a plant. The structure you will see, man will be witness to the development of races in the space now that you take into space. You cannot interact, but you can observe the way we done for thousands of years. The process is the simplicity of it, but if you make it complicated, you need peer review papers to confirm it. I peer review my papers because I've been there, I've seen it through. So, Professor Gao, I hope you got the message and you can pass the message to the scientists in the Chinese space technology. We need to take the spaceship program as fast as possible to final level in the coming weeks, that at least we can protect the territorial lands of China. Because the others will have created enough mess, they'll be too busy cleaning up the mess. The only option at this stage is development of the new technology, which can stand the hailstones of sand, hot lava and the rest of it. we should be able to have enough knowledge, as we've done, that you're creating a gas, you can heal the burns from the stones, or the heat of the fire which comes from the sky. You have to be able to stand when there is darkness and no vegetation growing, to feed your loved ones. Gas water, in different shape or form, will give you enough, because it's the field of the plasma. You need to rescue. You'll be amazed how fast the governments will start running to develop the technology, because now it's them. Go back on the teachings. Every single one of you, open as many networks as teaching how to make GANs, how to make it, how, what it does, if you burn, how it does, and spread the knowledge as you are the messengers of the peace. Don't get battled in who's right or who's wrong. Don't get battled into who told me what. You're all right and you do it your own way, and it's always correct because you deal with the field of the plasma. Any questions?
Thank you, Mr. Keshe. So we have some people that have their hands up that will promote to panelists so they can ask a question there. There was Tony Connell, did you have a question? I'll unmute you. Hello, Tony, did you have a Tommy, rather?
Can you hear my microphone?
Yes, we can hear you.
I just have a quick question for Mr. Keshe. I wanted to show him a new GANs making methodology and have him comment on it. Can I show two pictures that I took of my setup?
Can we do that after, when we finish with this part, please?
That would be okay. Fine. I'll be here.
Okay, remind me later and we'll entertain that. Okay. So any other questions that are relevant to the teaching that we just had here?
Mario had a question there in the Zoom chat.
I do have a question.
You mean on the update on the Chinese development?
Yeah.
He says an update on the Chinese development would be great. Is that something that you want to share right now, Mr. Keshe, or shall we try to focus on this?
The Chinese development, as you know, we are in close contact with the Chinese through the Keshe Foundation China. We have established a common line communication with Professor Xu. Professor Xu is directly in charge of all the works of the Keshe Foundation and how we will develop the technology in China. There is a large funding being raised by the Chinese for development and the spread of the technology in China. I was speaking to them yesterday. We are talking huge amount of funds has been raised to develop in the coming weeks. I will be spending a year or two in China to see the full development of the space and every other aspects of the technology, in conjunction with the Chinese officials, government, Keshe Foundations, and we are waiting for a process of clearance to go through. Once we get into that position, our main target, as we have agreed with Professor Xu and the Chinese side of the work of the Foundation, is the rapid development of the Oasis systems, that it can be available to all the Chinese across China. This is our main target. When we talk about the Oasis system, we're talking about the water, food, heat and shelter. They're working on a number of designs, they're working on different aspects of the technology, and on our arrival, we'll sit on the table with our knowledge seekers in China, which is in huge numbers, for them to tell us how they see it and how we can support to do. Most probably daily teaching the way we do here in China will become a norm for us, that we can translate everything possible. We have requested, and in the coming days, all the Keshe Foundation, all the teachings, all the paperwork, which has been transcribed, all the knowledge seekers will be sent to China for immediate translation into Chinese, that it can be used for different aspects. Chinese scientists and officials have understood the beauty of the technology, the way the universe works, independent of the messenger. And they will use it because it's close to their understanding. We will develop the spaceship program very rapidly in China. Most probably, the Spaceship Institute, those of you who applied and you complete the payment to join us, you will come to China. These are the last things we have to do at the moment, it's not confirmed. Once we agree, the spaceship program teaching will be in China. I'm proud to be part of it, and we'll have the Chinese space scientists working with us to develop it very rapidly. I think most of you should have had the hint that we're going to be in China. This is what our plan is. As we said, we'll be there for 1 or 2 years. So, those of you applied to become Mojans, complete the process within next week or two, because we are going to close it. We close it very rapidly, because we'll have enough students in China to support, and we have enough financial solid background in China, which is raised to complete the space technology for the Chinese community.
Will the updates be published on the OASIS system, so that everyone can build it?
The update will be with the hand of the Chinese Keshe Foundation. We will complete it in China, and then it is in the hand of Chinese government and Chinese Keshe Foundation, and our spokesman, Professor Xu, in China. It will not, their version will not be released unless they agree to do it, which I think they will do. But Chinese are proud to share knowledge. But in a way, it has to be, because the emergence of what has been explained in past are here has alerted the Chinese government for rapid development of OASIS system, because there is not enough food to take across. And don't forget, the Chinese are well trained. They know how difficult it is to get clean water, to get shelter, to get food in disaster areas. We've seen them having major earthquakes in the past years. So, our prime target, as we have agreed with our colleagues, will be OASIS system. On my arrival, after we settle down in a couple of days, we start the full process. All the Chinese Keshe Foundation groups, all the Chinese Keshe Foundation laboratories, all become under cover of the working directly to pass the knowledge to the Chinese scientists and Chinese people. We are extremely alert and aware of the threats by US government on my movement to America, and by the Jewish lobby. But I tell you one thing, in us moving to China safely, is a lifeline for your nations. Any other question?
Guy actually had a question here. Guy, go ahead.
Yes, Mr. Keshe, I don't know, I was not really clear about the timeline here, about all these events. If there's something happening here in America, we're talking about here a super volcano in Yellowstone, and I know that recently there was a lot of activities there. Usually they say to be prepared is a very wise move. So if we're talking about a timeline, we're talking about within 6 months or within a year?
The timeline has already started millions of years ago. Now this is the final axe for the gain, it'll go. Once he starts the pin released in Chile a few months ago, as we said, now we see the activities on one small portion, as you see in the North and Southern America. You see how heavily it's concentrated in one place, because there is a pressure. A huge amount of pressure is building up for it to happen. It's not that it's going to hear a big bang. Is it sliding and releasing? And in the compression, the volcanic eruption in Yellowstones and in the Central America is inevitable, because they are taking a lot of pressure from underneath. You got to realize one thing, that the solid mass is not flat underneath too. The same as on the top, it has hills and troughs and everything else. So the main mass is pushing underneath to the solid part of the continental mass of the South America, and it will happen. The pressure is going through the center. You have to look in the real condition, the line of the Central America and the Yellowstone. This is important, because if you look, you understand why. I brought the globe here, if you can extend it. Fabio, if you can bring the camera forward, you will understand why it's going this way. This is partially correct, but if you take exact position on the line, you will see where you're going to go. It passes, it has no choice. The planet is shifting on the same line. We are not going up that way. We are going on the landmass turn of the event. Look at the shape, you see the mass is twisting, pushing itself away. So now the push, this becoming a straight, has blocked. So this mass has stopped, but this mass was going. In fact, if you look at it, you go like this. So now it's in line. Yellowstone, the central part, what you call Midwest, all come into the same twist. West coast of Canada, it's heavily vulnerable. Heavily vulnerable. There are two or three volcanoes, which they sit under the North Pole. We've never seen. They will crack up, and the steam they'll create will create a huge problem in the Northern Hemisphere. Because they just come under the snow. Look at the line, it just hits the correct way. If you look, if you can go very close, you see the Gibraltar and the Southern Spain, Portugal will start the push, because now it separates. And then we see the closure of the 100%. In the next few hundred years, we'll have a lake here more than the channel to go to the Suez Canal, because it will close. This is so narrow that it will close. And then it closes the, what we call the Persian Gulf, will become a lake. It'll totally become one landmass, it'll push itself through, and it'll happen in time. This is not that as a piece you see, you can go to a Western movie and everything happens from beginning to the end in 2 hours. It's hundreds of thousands of years. And as I said, if you could look at the separation of this landmass, trace it back to the time of what you call the end of the life on this planet and the new cycle, what we call the end of dinosaurs, no meteorite has ever hit the planet. The same thing will happen here. Any other question?
Mr. Keshe, there's a question from Stephen Hamper, who asks, Mr. Keshe, should we be going to Rome in September for council meeting, or stay at home to help?
If you're a council member, a supporter council member, as in our talks yesterday, we had with the 40 odd council members online, you don't need to be in Rome, because in fact, we are not building another UN conference. The whole position is that you are there for your nations, you are there for your language speaking of your country, and so be amongst your people, that more people come to know how you are there to serve them than being present. We open Zoom channels live during the conference across the planet for the council members. It'll be nice to have you, it'll be fantastic to see number of you, but this has to be a global event that all the members of the community are part of, not something happening in Rome. We are not organizing hundreds of or a thousand auditorium in Europe. We especially chose a little that in time we can explain to you. Being part of it is good, but now that the Universal Council is taking shape, you are the guardians of humanity in a correct conduct in the time to come. There'll be no United Nations. The first thing that's happened in this position, which comes in the next few months, you'll find out that all the United Nations ambassadors will be running home. They come to you, because they'll be claiming the first seats on the planes, because we are a member, we are the head of the United Nations, we are part of the United Nations. There is no nation to be united now. And as a council members, it's for you to be, to learn, to teach and support. If you're on planet Zeus or in Mars, do you come back to Earth for every conference? Or you bring the people which are part of you into the organization of the running and understanding the structure. You becoming a global, universal organizations. So, start looking outward, not inward. As I said, there is no title to go with it. Facilities to be able to serve will be provided, but the rest is on you. As I said, we never ask for donations. There is a line of donations, but interesting enough, nobody, hardly anyone compared to what we put outside, has donated anything to the foundation. Because, as I said, you're all takers. You made the pen, you made the system, you made your Magraph system, you went to doctors who have the technology, you made the pads, and that's thank you very much. We took it free. We don't ask, but man has to learn. Magraph system is takes, and the more it gives, is there for us to serve. So, you'll see, you don't need to donate funds, but you donate your time and soul to serve humanity. You do not need to be in the council meeting in Rome. You're welcome, but remember one thing. What do you do if there is no plane by September? Very real possibility. This is not something which I just talk. This is something which I can open my phone and read it to you as I've done before. Would there be a November election in United States? Or would the Senate or people leave Obama to become for a third and a fourth and then maybe the fifth time president, because there'll be nobody else to head the nation? Quite a high possibility. We warn the world leaders of such events, and Americans read every single communication out of my phone and in my phone, so they already know. Organize events that Keshe Foundation people can come as a member of the council to be with you, to support you, to spread the message of peace and the systems that you can develop it. You have a problem? Pardon? You want my mouse? Oh, we see something new.
Why? Yeah, this is Flint. I just pulled up a recent map of the earthquakes in Yellowstone area in the last 2 weeks.
Could you expand it, please? You see, we see now, there was initially these are all 0.7 magnitude. Yesterday there was a 4-point magnitude. If you go on the 16th, 15th, somewhere we saw a report of 4-point magnitude earthquake. You see, they are very shallow, very, very shallow. When you see earthquake this shallow, it means the magma is very close to the surface.
Mr. Keshe, there was a 4.0 earthquake, looks like 1.5 or 2 days ago, and right at West Yellowstone in Montana.
Yeah. It's building up. It's building up because the pressure, you go back, can you small it? Can you go backwards, please? Go positive. Go positive, go positive. Okay, you see, stay there. This pressure here from this pool is pulling the skin, and the pressure is building up here. And when the pressure builds up here, it's taking everything, the magma is weak, will erupt, will cover most of the, what do you call it, West Coast, Midwest. The whole of Los Angeles, San Diego will go in no time. Arizona, possibly on the verge, will get totally blocked. Anywhere in this region, we'll see massive losses. Because you got to find something else, which is a part of the whole problem. Here, the two oceans link up back again. Atlantic and Pacific will come together. This is, do you see the pressure is there? Just if you look at, just look how heavy the pressure is here. And this is the push, and we see the push on Peru. So this is pushing, magma is pulling this way, this is a snapping, this is going. And when this goes, the top skin gets pulled, the pressure is coming. This is very much, if you look at it, if I sit this way and you try to push me from the back and pull my leg, all the pressure goes in my lung. This is the lung of the volcano. If I put my leg on your back and somebody pulls your leg forward, you're exactly in the position of American continent. The lung, the heart is taking the pressure because the landmass beyond this part is holding on. So the soft part, like your organ, when you play the accordion, collapses, pops out. This there is very, very clear. Extremely clear. And this is the problem. This is why you don't see much earthquakes on this side of Los Angeles and the west coast of California, because it's pulled to the stretch. Now it's time for this to go, and then this goes, and the skin goes back, and all the plates free themselves. The Lyle in California is the biggest problem, is the biggest indicator of the beginning of the earthquakes. Because this will go, the skin is pulled, you can't pull this anymore. Now, the release to go, and it's like a spring will go back within a matter of seconds. Then we start seeing sequence of earthquakes around the world, volcanic eruptions literally come to an end in a matter of a few years, and then we'll see relining of the continents. The, what is the, if we can get the full Asian continent into this, please? Can you reduce it? What it is, what you see here, this is a danger point in the future. Because now, this mass, if it pushes, we'll pull this one open, we start seeing a series of earthquakes around India. Saudi Arabia becomes an earthquake zone. In so many ways, all this will open up. Most probably, the Caspian Sea will open in long term back into the Atlantic Ocean, but that's a very, very long time. The, you don't need to imagine anything. This is a data by the American organization. Go on the other channels, you get more and more data, and then you will see this is the problem. This is the biggest problem. This line here is the biggest warning we're about to go. If this would have, if we would have had shift, seismic shift here, we would have had earthquake in Los Angeles area, in California, in Western Canada, we had time. But now there is no more, not so much. It means the skin is pulled fully, the pressure is taken by the center, we're about to go. It's just matter of the last, as we say, is the last straw which breaks the back of the camel. This is a warning to the governments. They don't listen, or they say it's too late. Because don't forget at the moment, the decision made by the Iranian government is the same. The damage is so horrendous in Tehran that we leave it and we create a new capital. This is the decision of the Iranian government, official decision. Because we cannot handle the losses of millions. You have to understand the structure of Tehran. Tehran is on hills, continuous hills, and all the houses are built in three or four story high, next to each other. Once you get the earthquake, one goes, the whole lot go. There it goes, 5,000 people down the hill. Each apartment holds three, four or five people. You have six floors on each average, 20, you get 40 of them going, there it goes. And then is one connected to the other. Iranian government policy is very clear. We'll do nothing when the earthquake happens, we just move the capital. Because we don't have the resources to do. But unfortunately, the American nation is so bankrupt that you can't even find a new capital. We've got to stay where you are, if it's still intact. The biggest bankrupt nation claiming the first in the world. How is possible? We don't understand. Now, we see the repetition of Louisiana. When it comes, you'll find out, as we say in the English word, fair coats and no knickers, which means very looking very good, but nothing underneath to keep yourself warm. The fair coats will blow out very way. The only people who carry their fair coats and they have everything underneath of it is the Chinese and the Russians. In Europe, it's already stripped. If you are a European citizen, every town hall, every statue, every column you see in your city is already mortgaged. Up to the hilt, loaned to the bankers in the West. You don't own anything. When you go and see your town hall, ask them how much town hall has been debted. Most of the town halls, most of the statues in your cities in Europe, is already pre-sold or loaned for the money to do the things they could not pay, because they could not steal from the rest of the world the way they used to. The fact will come up, and then you have to face it. We saw what happened in Arizona, we saw what happens in Louisiana, and we'll see the rest of it. In Louisiana, everybody thought America was a very rich country. We saw worse condition than Africa. Worse condition than Africa. And it's taken them years, they haven't managed to sort out a small flood, let alone such a situation. Don't forget, as I said before, California is the eighth largest economy on this planet, and it's going to go. So the America goes to somewhere below the fifth and the sixth nation in the world, because the main part of the support of economical support will not be there. And the other problem is, as I warned, in the governments, when such a scale happens, Fukushima was a child's play. Would this make a new race out of human race, which can stand radiation? Most probably. Would we mutate to a new form, or would we take to space because we cannot understand the environment? I give all my support to the Chinese government to see them into space as rapid as possible in a correct way. And this is where we are committed to, and we'll carry on our commitment. In the West, they have silenced the technology that they carry on with their abuse, so they stay with it as it is. As not many people know in the West how to use to make little things to help themselves, to their dogs or their family. So, what doesn't exist, you don't miss. Next question.
Yes, Mr. Keshe, I have a question here from Peter in that regard.
Hello, Mr. Keshe. A quick question here. What about using nanocell technology and frequency accumulation techniques to reverse engineer a toxic environment back to pristine condition?
Why not? Why not? If you understand how to do it, merge all the sciences of the man. It's not just one. Or merge all the what you know in what can be done and share the knowledge freely. I explained to you something very interesting. Keshe Foundation became a number of time recipients of large donations. Jewish lobby threatened the bank. If you accept the money, it will be this and that. So they deprived the Keshe Foundation to develop centers around the world by the finances. But my deepest commiseration to Jewish lobby is, now there shall be no State of Israel, because we haven't got anything to help you with. Because you shot yourself in the foot. You will understand how nations and the people who played games will be played games by their own act, by themselves. We protect and develop the technology in Italy rapidly. It's our home base. Any other question?
Yeah, there's Francois.
Are we too ashamed to be human? Now that we know what is about and what we've done is the cause of our own demise.
Well, Francois mentions maybe we should all start to build a device that will clean the air above us from the dust and chemtrail and pollution and clouds, etc., so we can keep the sun shining above us. If MK would give us all the blueprint for that now, we will make it.
You had the blueprint, the green print, the red print, every other print. I don't know in any other way to teach you. If you understood what we are doing in China, is when you make a dome, you have everything you need from your dome. The light, the heat, the light of the sun. Because it's an interaction of the field. You got to understand, the Keshe Foundation, the supporters of Keshe Foundation in China have raised millions in the past 2-3 months. They have raised millions and millions of dollars to support the development of the technology once we arrive. And in the West, we see nothing but boycotts and cuts and threats. Any television channel teaching the technology has been silenced and threatened by the Jewish lobby sitting in different parts of the world. And by the Third Reich in Germany. Now they pay for their own deeds. We close our doors when the time comes, and we decide the time and the position. That's their motto. Now the time has come. Next question.
I have a question here in Oslo, Monique. I come from Monaco, and I understand my family is going under the water. I never supported any of the elected government in Europe, but I was born in Europe, so I never voted because I never supported the political system. And now, in other words, because I was dropped, my parents created me in Europe, I'm going to get punished because of that?
It's not a punishment. It's, look at it the other way. Why don't you use your life to serve, to help the others when the time comes in different ways and shapes?
Of course. That's my complete intention.
It's not a punishment. It's a pleasure to serve. Don't forget, the European monarchies have created their own problem. Monaco, Belgium, Holland. And in time, they create most of the problem for themselves, and they'll stay that way. It's very interesting. We look at the political situation now in France. A government which came into power out of the false bombing and whatever, now is getting bombed every day in Paris by their own people who found out how they got in. They used the race and religion to create a mayhem, to get the votes. Now they're in, they don't know how to get themselves out of it. We see it now, we'll see this the same. They repeated the same in Belgium. They thought they can cause that to bring mayhem between the races, and it didn't work. People become wise to it. A lot of people nowadays don't look across the nationality and religion and the color. They become wise to how governments work. And that's the work of most of the Keshe Foundation supporters. And that's what I say, we become one nation, one planet. Because we see across the work of these people. You're in Monaco, in one of the most beautiful part of the world. You have an opportunity to work with the French. You have the opportunity to work with the Italians near you and the rest. You have a solid background with people like what we have in the French teaching.
So, in other words, I live in Oslo, I have to go back to Monaco.
Pardon?
To help. I live in Oslo, so I have to, you would think that it's a better action on my side to go down and help out?
Teach as many as you can where you are how to save themselves. A Maghreb system is irrelevant because you can do different things with different aspects of technology. If you understand the technology and can teach it, people can help. We've seen people in Oslo, how they're working around the Keshe Foundation. We've seen people in South America, how they work around the work of the Keshe Foundation, what they see. We see the same in China and the rest. It's learning how to work together to bring the technology to be accessible by a lot. I have a very bad news, because what we see it, the outcome of this process will create a lot of problem in Germany. The outcome of this process in the coming time, if you don't understand it, I explain to you in a very simple way. German economy will be devastated. German economy and the lifestyle in Germany will be devastated, because the Germans and the French packed together to make the EU to do what Hitler wanted to do and did with draining the central banks. And they created the euro, and they emptied all the central banks into bond. Now that this disaster is about to happen, the governments go to bond to get their goals out to be able to support the nationals. you have to understand the process. It's so volatile. The situation, once it comes up, is so horrendous that most of the European nations need 3 passports before even crossing the border with one. The way they blocked the entrance of the people, refugees from a different part of the world in past year, we watch, very soon they'll be on the same door themselves. We've seen this happening. If you go to Russia, and if you are of a German descent, you know exactly what I'm talking about. After the Second World War, there wasn't enough money in Germany to pay for the mayhem they created in Russia. Russia took a large number of Germans as payment, as free labor. And they took them to a position that they could never come back, and they could use them to serve for what they've done wrong to them. That city where part of these Germans were taken is the capital of Almaty, of the Kazakhstan today. That's why the capital was moved to there. The same will happen and repeat themselves again, if the humanity doesn't watch. A lot of you don't know what happened in the Second World War, but go back into Germany and ask how many people came from Astana. It was a German city in the heart of Russia, built by the payment of the death of the life of the people who served the German army. When you go to capital of Kazakhstan, you see a German city, you don't see a Russian city. So the same will repeat itself again. People will pay in different ways if, as Keshe Foundation, we do not disturb the balance by sharing the knowledge freely, that people don't care, wherever they are, they can survive. The history of man is very dirty in what they've done to each other.
Yes, Mr. Keshe, Monique again, but it is always the people in charge who lie to the people underneath in every single nation.
You cannot lie to, let me explain, you cannot lie to yourself. You teach, you serve, irrespective of where you sit. That's what you have to carry with you. Irrespective of who sits at what government, no government tells you, you can't get a copper plate and a zinc plate and walk to a man with children which is hungry, make the right things for them and say, drink from this water. Even if it's a dirty water from the street, you've seen from Ghana teaching us, become purified, becomes a water to drink, becomes a food if you energize it the right way. So don't blame governments. You put the governments there. You voted. You say you didn't vote, the others did, or they voted for themselves, they are in the seat of power. But don't forget, these people are temporary seaters. When I was very young, in my early 1920s, I got to know a man, he was living in one room with one cooker in one corner and one bed, hardly any human life, just a bit of sheet of cover, living in what you call in England the social services, social security. And one day I was in his room because I was the landlord, I had to check something. There were like a booklet on his table. He used to be part of the office of the mayor and to become the mayor of one of the major cities of England. And now he was living in a, what I call, small room with one bed and nowhere to go. These politicians are temporary people. Soon they vanish. It's you who put them there, but if you teach them knowledge, there is nobody will be the leader. That's why there'll be no kingship. Change your mindset, be there to serve, and then you'll see what happens. Doesn't matter if you're in Oslo, you're in Cannes, you're in London, or wherever. The monarchies will run in a time coming, because people, when they're hungry, the first thing they go is for the rich, and the kings have stashed a lot away. But I wonder how much gold can the people eat, because it doesn't become a food. Unless you teach them how to make cans of gold, and then they have every energy they need to live. This is the difference. When you come to a man, give him a piece of copper and say, eat it. What will, can you eat this if it's food? And show him how you can change it into a gas, how it gives energy, how it heals him. Then he understands. Don't walk with the gas. Give him a piece of metal. What happens? Can you eat this? No. A piece of wire from his home, he understands that's a wire. But you show him, it doesn't carry the current for the light, but it carries the current for life. Make it simple. Make it understandable. Make it reachable by the public. We have millions and millions of supporters without ever being mentioned on any radio or television, because we are threat. And we know who we are threat to. The ones who abuse, they want to carry on. But very soon, they will not find a seat on no plane to escape. They have to stay with the people they abused. It's the same with the State of Israel. I keep on warning the Jewish community, be ready, because what you've done wrong, you didn't learn what it was done wrong to you. I warn my cousins on continuous basis. It's for them to understand. They think they sit on the seat, they have a big brother following, supporting them. As we know, Israel is a state of United States, that's called the State of Israel. When there is no United States, shall be no State of Israel, because it'll be eaten up in no time. They can't nuclear bomb themselves, so the nuclear bombs stays in their bunkers. This is how bad it is. This is why we put the hand of peace both to Israelis and the Jews and the Palestinians and the Muslims. Soon they have no choice. We have no choice. Doesn't matter what you are, it all becomes one. It's for you to teach the way I do. You've seen the troubles, the attempted murder on us, the shooting they tried to do us, the poison they us. I don't want to stop. I teach. Maybe you can learn. There should be, if you're committed to serve humanity, there should be nothing to stop you from serving, unless it's you with an excuse. We are here to serve. You have to choose.
Of course we wish to serve. That's, we are part of the Keshe Foundation.
It's up to you how to serve. Any other question?
Is there anyone from the panelists list that would like to speak right now? You can unmute your microphone and ask a question and on the topic.
Hello, Rick, this is Tommy from Texas. Can I do my quick question now?
What do you think, Mr. Keshe? Are we, do we want to keep on topic here, or are we open to some
that,
other?
If it's that important to you, yes, why not?
Yeah, it is. I've been spending a lot of money and time on this, so I wanted to get this down. And I think you can answer this quickly. I'm going to try to share my screen. I have three pictures. And let's see. Can you see my setup?
Yes.
Okay, we have three glass vases, 8 inches tall, 2 inches wide, filled with salt water. The elements, copper and zinc, are pure. On the left side, on the outside of each vase, is a nano-coated copper plate. Inside the vase hangs the zinc plates, and there are no wire connections to the nano-coated copper plates. And now if we go to the second picture, I'm going to show you the GANs. As you can see, I'm getting a white, fluffy GANs. And then there is a third picture, and I have a question. This picture was taken off the Golden Age of GANs. It shows two test tubes, and it's somebody's idea of what pure CO2 GANS looks like and pure zinc oxide GANS looks like. Can I show that picture?
Please.
Okay, you see the CO2 GANS looks somewhat translucent, and the zinc oxide GANS looks very fluffy and white. So if you look at my GANS, it looks very fluffy and white. My knowledge says that that setup should be creating pure CO2 GANS.
Your setup still produces CO2 GANS.
Yes, but is it?
Yes. It's is just it? By the color, you don't go what is there. Depends what kind of zinc you have, what conditions you created. One of the doctors in the doctor team, which we teach on Wednesdays, produces more or less the same kind of thing, and in conjunction with kind of fruit in South America, she uses for helping her patients without any connection with copper oxide out or the zinc plate out.
Would you say that I have made pure CO2 GANS here?
More or less, yes.
Okay, and a question has come up several times.
But the question is, what are you going to do with it?
Many things.
I hope it's positive.
And I'm also training 20 different people, so I had to get this right. You made me forget my question.
Yeah, but the thing is, do a reverse test. Put the nano-coated copper inside and put the zinc outside. See what you get.
Well, I'm trying not to nanocoat 15,000 plates every 2 days, so that's why I wanted the nanocoating on the outside. If you're happy, I have CO2.
Stop. What do you mean by 15,000 plates?
Well, there's a big issue on nanocoating plates. A lot of people say their nanocoating comes off after a couple of days. Some people say their plates are indestructible. I don't know what the truth is, but if it's on the outside, then I don't care because the nanocoating is not going to come off.
Why do you want to make 15,000 of them?
I need to make a lot for myself, and I'm training a lot of other people, and I'm giving some of it away. So, like I said, I'm trying to educate a lot of people, and I want to get this straight so I tell them the right things.
Yes, but try the other way around too.
Just.
And then you will see, because with what you put in there as a zinc, partially you have zinc oxide in it as well.
Okay, but predominantly CO2?
Depends on the size of the opening on top of your bottle.
Okay, I'm going to put bubblers in there too. I'm going to be feeding air into it.
I was suggesting to Armin, one of the easiest way to make CO2 is to buy yourself these gas cylinders of CO2 you use at home for making fizzy drinks.
Yeah.
And releases it slowly into the system, but it's already CO2, but you need a carbon gas. Gas of carbon is not very easy to buy. When I asked for it in Tehran from the Iranian officials, they said, you're crazy, what do you want to do with it? I said, you will understand when I use it.
Yeah, I already have a tank, but I thought the big thing was getting the oxygen into the water to combine with the plasmatic carbon.
But the thing is, if you're looking for a speed up process, it's no use putting oxygen there when you don't have enough carbon.
I thought the carbon was a matter of plasmatic fields between the copper and zinc plates joining. Yeah.
But how much can you pull from the small opening on the top of your system? Very little.
Well, I've got a big compressor and I'm going to be pushing a lot of oxygen, a lot of air into this water.
Yes, but you need the carbon fields or carbon in the atmosphere around you to be able to do it.
Okay, I didn't know.
No oxygen, but you need to create the condition of the carbon presence too that you can make a gas of it.
Okay, I already have a CO2 tank. I'll try to work on that. But you're happy that I...
Try to work on the carbon, not the CO2.
Not the oxygen.
No, because then you'd have to change the atomic carbon into the, the GANS of carbon. It can be done, it's very easy to be done. But you're trying to make a CO2 into a GANS. Try it and see what happens. Maybe the condition you create is right for it. You see, you're never wrong. Till you don't try, we don't know.
Okay.
So educate us.
Okay, would you say that I'm producing quantity sufficient of CO2 GANs at this second?
You need to do, you need to understand, test it. It's very easy to test if you're creating carbon, CO2 or zinc oxide. Drink GANs water of it and you see how you feel.
Okay.
You are a test tube, because if you both are part of the structure of your body. If you produce zinc oxide, and it is zinc oxide you think, in drinking it, you'll find peaceful condition. You become the meter. If you produce a CO2, you'll find different interaction with the environment as not so much peaceful, but a lot of energy, a lot of concentration.
Good. Okay, well, thanks for answering my question.
You're quite welcome. Thank you for carrying on the technology.
Can I add something in here? I've been making the pure CO2 and zinc. What you're making there is a zinc combination with CO2. If you want to make the pure CO2, the zinc needs to be not touching the water. And you can look at your zinc plates to see if it's coming off.
So put the zinc on the outside.
Yeah. I have mine in really thin plastic bags in large, but my container is about 2 feet long and a foot wide.
And you're not worried about the filtering the fields through the plastic?
No, it just slows down the process. The CO2 takes a lot longer to produce.
Great.
This is what we suggested some time ago, and that's what Brad does. If you put your plates totally outside, what you produce inside 100% is CO2.
Great. That's the answer.
Thank you very much. But you have to measure. It depends what you have, what your glass is composed of, what the plastic container is composed of.
Okay.
It'll be interesting if you're putting, I never thought this, but maybe somebody has got hold of it, but you can do it a different way. If you put your copper plates nano-coated outside, and you put a zinc plate on the other side, you're trying to transfer the fields of the zinc. If you're using fields or plates outside the zone with the water inside, or you don't even need the water is a media for you to get a confirmation of it. Can I have my white screen back, please? Can you stop sharing that I can have my white screen back? You see, I touched on this very early teachings and nobody picked on it because, as I say, Armon wrote me something very nice. He said, you have a patience of the universe and not the patience of the elephant. You wait till things happen, you don't mind. So, if this is your container and you put your copper oxides nano-coated and you put a zinc on the other side, the whole purpose is to produce a field of carbon. When you are outside, why don't you nano-coat your zinc plates too? Because now the field of nano-coat goes further than the matter state. And you still get the same rate of production, even more. If you are in water, yes, okay, put your zinc and a copper. But if you do it outside, I mentioned this in one of the teachings and nobody picked on it and I repeated it a couple of times, nobody understood and that's how it was left. Because now the matter state has a field to hear. The zinc state of nanomaterial has here. Why don't you get nano-coated copper and zinc nano-coated or the GANs and put it in the water, you still create carbon, you still will create CO2. But with a stronger field, because this is the beauty of this technology. You haven't changed the material on your plate, it's the same plate. But by making the GANs of it or nanomaterial of it, matter state field is this much from the plate. Nano is this much. When you have a GANs, it's this much. This is what I tell you, the technology, the knowledge has become a spoon-fed knowledge, and this is, I feed when I want, so I'm in charge. But this is wrong, because you have to be in charge, you have to extend the knowledge. You've seen this, I talked about this even a couple of weeks ago. Go back on the knowledge, go back on what was taught, add to the knowledge, or understand the knowledge correctly. Let's expand on this. Now we are here. I was talking about this with Caroline last night, last night. She says, she was asking me the question, what is that? I said, now I understand. This is the repetition of the lesson to Caroline last night on the dinner table. You have a plate. Up to now, you put the plates inside. This is what you've done. And you create a CO2. Some of you dared a little bit to go further. This is the problem with you lot. Don't go little, go all the way. If you understand it, you go all the way. If you don't understand it, you go little. See, let other make mistakes. You already made a mistake, you joined the Keshe Foundation. So make all the mistakes all the way through. So you put in there, you're happy, you put your zinc plate inside, and you're nano-coated because you don't want to lose your nano-coating in it. So it means you haven't understood the totality of the knowledge. You're working with the field plasma. We call it the field plasma technology. So go back to what the others did if you don't feel safe. Orange. Zinc oxide. Copper oxide, CH3, and give me a color, amino acid. What you did, you filled up with water, you drank it, oh yes, it tastes like an orange, it feels like an orange, and I feel good. So, why can't you translate the knowledge across? If you could bring the feel and the taste of the orange here by putting the ganses outside, how far are we from the technology understanding? Now, do the same with your zinc. Put your zinc outside, gans of it, put your nano-coated gans of the copper, you still make the field of carbon. You make a pure CO2. Massive amount. You don't need to be inside it. But you still have one dilemma, because you can't see it, it can't be there. You put it in the water to see it at the bottom. But we moved from this. This is last century teaching. 3 weeks, 3 months ago in Keshe Foundation, like 1,000 years evolution of the man understanding. This is from 1,000 years ago, donkey time. We have moved to field technology. You still have a gans, you understood that much, you have your ganses there, you have created a field. So, in this space, there is a field of the copper without oxidization. You put the water in, now you have a carbon. If you can convert this field, you will receive a pure diamond. I spoke how to make crystals, you never listened. It's the repetition. Put the water in there, you want CO2, you get CO2. Extend the knowledge further. I want to know how many of you will do this. You made the orange juice water, put the orange here, and now do the reverse. And try to breathe from the environment on the top. And see if you feel the taste of the orange, the energy of the orange. The answer is yes, before you try. But try it because you want to be convinced. Show me I believe it, because you don't even trust in the knowledge you carried. We entered from the plasma into field. We haven't changed the knowledge. It's the same. When you took the water, you drank it, you already entered the field plasma technology. But you need the water to confirm it. If you put the orange on the top of it without any water and breathe through it or walk in that space, you'll be literally, what can I say, swimming in the field of the oranges. You'll be orange in color as well if you want to stay there long enough. Because you haven't understood one part of it. The part I explained many times, vertical people are the same as horizontal people. And then they're all made of amino acid. That's why smell of orange, taste of orange, body of the orange is an amino acid, which you have created the balance for it, and it's trying to create a field balance. That's how you brought it here. This is what I was teaching yesterday to the doctors. Maybe you can understand, maybe we can teach you understand a little bit of it, but I'm sure you understand a lot of it. You had the orange, you had the fields, but you had to have a water to confirm you're right, because with the man has to see it to believe it. That's why we never believe anybody who says, I love you, because there is no bucket to show the size of the love. You have a system. You have a burned hand. You put amino acid, you put the zinc, you put the CH3, you put copper oxide, and a couple of other things if you understand it. You put the perfect hand, which hasn't been burned. You transfer the energy of here. You bring the burned hand and put it back up. The energy will heal you in no time. You have brought the replication of the totality of the structure into the plasma. Field plasma technology is far beyond the understanding of the man. You have a pain, you have a burn, because it's there. In the teachings I explained, use three different layers. Past few days, I taught this again and again. But you have to see the water to be able to do it. Then I believe it. Man has been made scared of his own shadow in accepting a new knowledge, because then they can't control it. And it's done nothing but by the church and the religion. And in the space, there is no religion and there is no church and mosques. Try it. This is what's called the field technology. I brought you in through, you checked, you're happy, you have a GANS, now become magicians. What do we call them? The people who played with chemicals and elements, they're called?
Alchemists.
Now you become plasmacist. Play with the field of plasma. This is what the universe is made of. The fields of the universe arise here, becomes you and me, the dog and the rest. Otherwise, it wasn't here. You have to create the condition of it. You have to understand the totality of it, because that's why you're not sure. Somebody else has shown that color. Mine is a slightly different color. Am I right? Of course you are. Lack of confidence is by taking the confidence, and what they've done to you, peer review. One of the things I think is going to be done in the new generation is to take PSBK out of the circulation. because it's become another peer review system, which is built in by the same people. Another means of control. Because they give you enough that they can control and what you can have. I will not donate a single cent to this organization because it's another structure of mind control. Better shot than you going around the internet, reading everyone's work, and then you take from them what you think according to you is correct. Not for people to take out. It's very strange. You put my name on internet, on PeaceWiki, I'm a criminal. You put me on Wikipedia, I don't exist. There is no such a creature on this planet called Keshe. I was there a few months ago, till we opened the hand of PeaceWiki, and the brother went with the sister. And then the Blue Circle came into operation. These are means of control. So, go on the internet, read everything. You become your own level of understanding. You're all sitting on the computer, put my name on Mehran Tavakkali Keshe on Wikipedia. I do not exist. 6-7 times people have tried it, they wipe it out because they learn, then they can't control. Then you go on a Facebook, put my name, international public figure. Which one do we believe in? And when we showed, PeaceWiki went on us being this and that, and now PeaceWiki is spending 25 years as a controller of other things in prison. So, we are correct, the term goes. Extend the knowledge, don't be afraid of learning something more or trying further. Because when you're the last man standing in a space, there is no references. You don't want to peer review anything because you have nothing else to peer review in your own life. Understand the technology is so beautiful, is the essence of the creation in every shape and form. Listen to the tape, what we play every day we start, is beyond the understanding of the man. Now you see, the knowledge is there, has been there from the beginning. You don't get a CO2, you don't get a feel of it, make a house, make a room, walk in it. What did we teach about space travel in the past couple of weeks? It's no different. As I said, teaching is complete, it's you who's got to start manipulating. But the problem is lack of confidence. Because they've taken that away from you, that's how they can manage to control you. Have confidence in what you do. There is nothing wrong, because instead of making CO2, you make zinc and CO2. So, this is what it is, what does it give me? What can I use it? How can I use it? How better I can use it? That's all it is. Have confidence in what you do, because they've taken the confidence from you. The first thing they do, has it been peer reviewed? You tell them, are you thieves or are you one of them? You want to control me. You've done it, you've gone that far, you want to teach it. Let them feel it's out of magic, out of air. They breathe the air which is nothing in it and they walk out without a cancer. This morning, we were supposed to have a presentation by a man who has spent a life past few months to create a gallon of water to help his wife out of a lung cancer. Now he tells us there are some signs of it or whatever on the lung and they don't think there is any more cancer. We know by the scan. But the wife, instead of appreciating what the knowledge has given and the life of the husband spent to support it, no, I don't want to be shown or to be known. Madam, the knowledge saved your life. It means you have not trust in your husband. That's all it is. The knowledge he brought, the time he went to the sea to make the gans of the sea for you to survive, you share life with the other mothers who have children. You should be proud to be shown that another mother with children with a lung cancer can be there to serve and be a mother to the children to come, not to be in the grave. Shame on humanity. Use it and then abuse it. This is the problem. This is where we go wrong. I'm okay, Jack. As we say in English, screw the others. You use the technology to save your life. A man gave his time. You should be proud to be, at least if you save a child, one child having a mother not dying of lung cancer, has no problem. This is what I discussed with the Chinese yesterday. Chinese community is developing so much, but we saw what happened with the mayhem, with the red circle creating in China and his hands, and now we are cleaning it up. Chinese community will shine like a star, the same as Africans. We have the videos or pictures of the process of the woman who's been saved partially or whatever by the plasma technology from lung cancer. We can't show it because she's upset that her name or pictures used. Shame on humanity. Where a child dies in next few months, where it can be saved, the others get the courage to be there to help the other children, to keep their mothers and the mothers to keep their children from lung cancer. Shame to be called human. Carry on. Any other question?
Okay. We have a question here from Peter.
You still have the pictures of the lung cancer lady. You have, am I correct, Rick?
We don't have any pictures of the lung cancer that I know of, but there's pictures from the Magrav device and questions about the Magrav device that he had.
He had. Okay. Now he knows who we are and we know who they are. Let them release it. It was supposed to be a PowerPoint representation of it. If you don't believe in saving it, it's saved, why do you want to talk about your energy? You wasted the energy. Next question.
Perhaps we'll hear from them next time around. Okay, yes, Peter has a question here, kind of a technical question.
Hello, Mr. Keshe. What is your opinion about using a frequency to excite the nano-coated metals? Would it increase the field strength and efficiency to produce more GANs?
I don't know. You test it and tell us. Because I never use it. Frequencies are the mule excite the matter state of the GANs, not the GANs.
Okay.
You understand?
Yes, sir.
It's very, very little because the matter state is the slowest one. It's the lowest strength. This question has risen a number of times in the past few days by different scientists we talked to. So, as I said, try it and you see what difference does it make. You will excite the liquid water within the gas, but you won't excite the gas because it's too powerful at the matter state even. And then you say, yeah, it excites the GANs. But what you actually do is what you do with the resonance frequency of the water. You change the water. It's the same as with Omoto in Japan. You don't do the GANs. You change, you increase the matter state electrons of the water of the GANs. That's a big difference. You understand? Peter?
Yes, sir. Yes, I do.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Keshe. Anybody else that's a panelist that has a question there?
Shall we call it a day? I think we gave enough today information.
Okay. If you feel that's correct.
What's the time?
We're at 3 hours into the show at this point.
12 o'clock. That's how we were supposed to be, 3 hour sessions.
Okay.
We become marathon sessions nowadays.
Yes.
4 hours, 5 hour runs.
It gets to be too much.
Yeah. As I said, next week I might not be here in the center. We don't know. We'll let you know if you're not. the teaching of God, as we call it, on the whiteboard. And I'll be back the following week.
Okay, very good, Mr. Keshe. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Please remember what we said about the refrigeration unit with your MagRaf system. If you have applied to become a Mojan, please complete the payments and be part of it. Yeah, we roughly might know where we're going to be. And then if you're coming to Rome to be as part of the Keshe Foundation, to become the new members of the Universal Council, please do so. Complete as fast as you can, because I'm going to close everything before I leave for China. There's no use joining a bandwagon when the bandwagon has already started. Thank you very much indeed for today. I hope we clearly defined our lines and our thoughts with the government. And it was requested by our friends to clarify certain points, and we hope we've done and understood by the world leaders who listen and have their eyes to the ground on what Keshe Foundation does and by how we work on the scientific basis and not on the imaginary basis, just to cover something up. Thank you very much for everything. See you next week.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Keshe. And that brings to a close the 118th Knowledge Seekers Workshop of the Keshe Foundation Spaceship Institute for June 16th, 2016. And as always, in the last 117 workshops, thank you everybody for attending. And we'll stop the live stream now.